Have you ever heard of wushou dancing?
Liyue Harbor is always changing, so it is only fitting that lantern
lights
turn.
Wushou dancing is famous in Chunyu Vale. Performers might be invited to promote the opening of a business or to spread good fortune during a holiday season.
Miss Farina is now one of my esteemed clients!
Is that hey, Adam. So?
You are quite right, Miss Su Tao.
He looks so cool.
How about we grab some dim sum from Chinya Kiosk? My treat! Congratulations! Up to it, Manzai!
A kite is always tied down, no matter how far it flies or how high it soars.
Oh wait, wait. Wait, it shows their new outfits.
A kite is always tied down, no matter how far it flies or...
Wow, I love the new Ganyu outfit. She looks really cute.
...or how high it soars. Oh kite, born of paper, flying true and sound, a lone traveler wanders, just waiting to be found.
I always believed we would see each other.
Wait,
again.
What? What? Hold on. Hold on a moment.
A lone traveler wanders, just waiting to be found.
I always
Is that Aether and Lumine side by side? What? No way. Okay, this is really interesting. I want to see what happens with this.
We would see each other again. That our days of separation would finally end.
Lantern Rite should be a day of reunion.
Cloud Retainer looking good.
I don't know. I don't remember.
You chose a path without a future.
Spare my innocent child. I alone am the source of this sin.
Wait. Those line of dialogues just sprinkled. I kind of want to hear them again. Hold on. Sorry.
I always believed we would see each other again. That our days of separation would finally end.
Our days of separation would finally end?
Lantern Rite should be a day of reunion.
I don't know. I don't remember.
I don't know.
You
don't remember.
You chose a path without a future.
You chose a path without a future. And he's crying. Spare my innocent child.
I'm the source of this sin.
Bro, this is very interesting. I want to see where it goes. Cool new boss.
One is fast on one
Cloud Retainer. Bro, her abilities look amazing. I am pulling for her on my main account. What? I want some! Bro, I'm hungry. They're having tea. That looks really cool.
Hello, travelers. It's your old friend Da Wei.
can increase.
大家好，我是阿然。 俏英庄这个名字大伟哥刚才也说有些印象，对吧？是啊，虽然具体在哪听过有点记不太清了，不过印象里是和茶有关。没错没错，我们陈玉谷的茶庄俏英庄一直都是以香茗猎泉闻名的，身后这个茶府可以说就是俏英庄香茶广受欢迎的秘宝了。这么厉害啊！毕竟这个茶府相传是仙人留下的仙家机关嘛。
No translation?
茶烤出的茶叶香气和口味确实是挺不一般的，而且坊间都流传俏英庄的水土得到过仙人的护佑。Okay,
hold on. The translation is hold on. Translation is separate because I'm watching in picture to picture. Hold on, let me fix it. Bro, how can I put translation? I'm just gonna keep watching like this, but I'll read what they say if I have to, if it's important. Otherwise, it's too complex. It just makes my life easier to watch it in picture like this, a lot easier. I had to cut windows.
Hello, travelers! It's your old friend, Da Wei.
大家好，我是阿然。
Hello everyone, my name is Rain.
Just now you
said that
Kyojin
Village sounds familiar.
I
can't remember right. Heard it, if I remember correctly, has something to do with tea. It's a tea village in Chenyu Vale. Cauldron is how the tea is made.
毕竟这个茶府相传是仙人留下的仙家机关嘛。
It was once an adaptable mechanism. Folk stories say the soil was blessed by the adepti.
哪怕不去考虑仙家机关的加持，茶叶本身的品质就已经非常不错。
Quality of tea leaves is outstanding.
虽然我不是什么品茶的这个专业人士啊，但我知道，同样挑选上等的茶叶，这茶叶啊也会因为各种因素的影响，导致最后味道。
Tea can change taste according to variety.
尝尝这个仙家机关炒出的茶是什么味道。不过这么特别的茶，会不会很难买啊？
So the tea is very hard to get because you need the leaves and the adaptive mechanism.
俏英庄的后山上都是大片大片的茶田，产出的茶也都会销售到璃月港，甚至是其他国家去。而且热情的俏英庄居民本身就很喜欢喝茶。
也很乐于用好茶来招待客人呢。他肯定得把。哦，his name is Jamin。Okay。游运单从，等等好茶都给你泡上尝尝。If you meet him, he's gonna bring you some tea。说到嘉明这个名字啊，听着就很亲切。嘉明他的性格热情健谈。He's talkative and full of zeal, and everybody loves spending time with him。虽然说他的老家是在俏英庄，但他人却经常在璃月港和仪陇部两地之间往返。
他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他的主业是镖师。他 太开心。不过佳明对武兽戏还真不是三分钟热度，他骨子里还是个很有坚持的人。他坚定的想要表演好武兽戏，在明月港
甚至更远的地方进行成绩。
这也是为了证明给家里看吧。最终他离开了家去追求梦想。
虽然现在的生活有点
辛苦，但佳明自己还
算活得开心。 His life is pretty tough right now, but he's pursuing his dream, so he's happy.
很有冲劲和闯劲啊，有机会还真挺想去看看他的武兽戏。
机会说不定已经近在眼前了哦。
哦，这感情好啊。
佳明这么喜爱武兽戏，他的技能天赋当然也和他有关了。要不然我就先给大伟哥介绍介绍，也算是提前满足一下你的好奇了。
原来是这么个近在眼前啊，可以可以。
Here we go.
Whether it takes me uphill, downhill, or out to the sticks, I get the goods from A to B. I'll even take him across the sea if needed. So don't worry, you're in safe hands. They don't call me the gold standard guard for nothing.
Cool moves, very cool moves. I'm pulling for him for sure.
Hop to it, Monzai!
佳明会将自己的武兽之法应用在各种场合，
He applies his dance moves to all kind of situations. Combat with something's beast. When he makes contact with the target, he leaps upward. Think of a follow that main. Sorry, let me read that for a second. Pounces forward using the Wushu arts, leaping high into the air after coming into contact with the target or surface. After Jia Ming has used Bestial Scent to rise into the air, he will use a specially powerful plunging attack, Charmed Cloud Strider, when performing a plunging. The damage from plunging attacks caused by Bestial Scent is converted to pyro damage, nice, that cannot be overridden by elemental infusions. Upon landing, Gaming will consume a fixed amount of HP. He cannot be reduced but below a certain amount by this method. The damage is considered plunging attack. I wonder if this would be good for like Burgeon. If it's AoE anyway. He can also recover HP when he comes in contact with his pet, which comes back to him after the plunge.
武兽态势持续期间, 只要佳明状态上佳, 还可再次换出文仔登场助力。
好精彩啊, 这战斗真像看了一场武兽戏。
能让大伟哥有这样的观感 就太好了。
We studied and borrowed many elements from traditional land dance culture, such as leaping, squatting, rolling, lunging, and circle steps.
扣步等等，再和现代元素相结合， 想要为大家呈现出一种具有霓虹质感和火焰包裹的全新武兽戏。
Neon-like texture, yeah, that's cool. It has some very shiny stuff on his armor.
另外，战斗聚焦在跳跃这个核心元素上呢。 也是想给大家传达一种步步高升的节奏氛围，还有文仔的加入，也希望在补足连击丰富度的同时，呈现出丰富的感觉。
Aside from creating loads of opportunities for combos, we hope really feels like a pair of beast dancing together。这要是在敲个锣打个鼓啊，喜庆的节日感一下子就出来了啊！是呀，而且说到海灯节，今年也有一位老朋友要来和我们一起过节。Speaking of Lantern Rite, old friend will be coming to celebrate with us。Cloud，就是那个女人。
刘云界风真君，果然大家都很喜欢他啊。哎，说到刘云真君啊，我想起来刚才收到了个消息啊，项目的同学给我发了个刘云界风真君的视频。He's
gonna show a video from Cloud Retainer.
能更了解他，我还没来得及看来着。来得早不如来得巧啊！来，和大家一起来看看。Here
we go. Damn.
Hello, 大家好呀！现在闲云的开发进度已经接近尾声了，或许大家和我一样，
She's almost ready to see the world.
也想知道研发同学们对这个角色有怎样的看法。那现在就让我们一起去。
She's gonna interview the devs to find out what they think about the character.
同学，能和我们聊一聊制作闲云这个角色的初衷吗？啊，其实很久以前啊，我们就有了将刘云界风真君化作人形游历世间的想法。
He's saying they already had the idea of her roaming the world in human form.
他就是出现在今后的故事里面更加自然更加顺畅吧，我们就借这次机会呢去把他的形象制作出来。
So they used the opportunity to create her character image and gave her a name to travel the mortal realms.
还是有很多可以挖掘的潜力，我就以下路攻击来举例吧。其实这个玩法在我们游戏中一直都存在。
He's talking about how plunging attacks have been part of the game since the beginning, but only have been useful for a very few characters, so she's gonna boost it for everyone. This guy just said I have no idea.
过程中我们也会遇到一些问题。啊？什么问题？咸鱼又出 bug
了。机关树当时做起来其实并不是很容易。
Okay, so they're saying the mechanism aspect wasn't easy to pull off.
不能太有科幻感，同时呢，because
they're trying not to look sci-fi but instead fantasy.
仙气飘飘，同时也要兼顾工科女的感觉。
在打磨元素战绩的过程当中遇到过一些问题。
When they were designing her elemental skill, they found a lot of problems.
一方面既要考虑空中的位移，又要考虑落地衔接的各种表现，还要考虑美术位移和程序位移之间的平衡关系。
元素战机在俯冲下来的时候很难观察到敌人。
变后冲击的镜头开始还是挺眩晕的，
提升了我的抗眩晕等级。
So at first she would change into a crane, but then they decided to like show the effect off screen so it wouldn't get in the way of combat.
大家还有什么想和玩家们说说的呢？
希望在 4.4 版本呢，我们大家都能从忙碌的生活中找到属于自己的清静，也希望大家能够喜欢上
This guy is just saying enjoy the game basically.
祝大家今年海灯节快乐，
希望大家多多玩原神，
祝大家都能抽到自己想要的角色。
And this guy is wishing you good luck on your pulls.
希望新的一年大家都能准时下班。
别骂了别骂了，求求了求求了。
And don't be too hard on us.
这里工作挺有意思的，希望有更多小伙伴一起加入原神。
不要和玄云握手，那是
Do not shake Cloud Retainer's hand too tightly.
那就给吕思哲们拜个早年吧。
Happy New Year. Don't want to spend the New Year's fixing bugs. That's funny.
那么今天的采访就到这里结束啦。希望各位旅行者们能喜欢仙云这个角色。大家再见。
不愧是那个女人，就连制作幕后都这么有个性。
But they didn't actually show her yet, right? Okay, here we go.
以人形的样貌见闻吧。
Hold on, let me read. One of the mighty and illuminated adeptia of Jun Yun, known as Cloud Retainer, expert in all kinds of mechanical contraptions. Her heart now turns towards the affairs of the mortal world, through which she walks under the name Shen Yun. Okay.
制服打扮虽然之前出现过，不过在我们面前大大方方的走来走去，确实还是第一次。
看来这里面又有故事。那他今年打算怎么过节呢？
这就要说到我们今年海灯节的主题。
The theme of the lantern ride is kites.
人间的机关奏物可是越来越稀奇古怪了。
风筝，这也不算什么稀奇古怪吧？
之前的确实不算，但今年从枫丹那边引进了神奇的机械装置，能够让风筝无风自起，飞得又高又稳。
你这么一说我就懂了，流云借风真君一定是起了莫名的攀比心吧？什么枫丹科技？
So they're saying that flaunting technology allowed kites to fly without gust of air, and this triggered Cloud Retainer's competitive side.
但性格一点也不差，敢爱敢恨，作风正直又富有侠义心肠。有时候好像有些心口不一，有时候又还有一点脱线，可他的幽默总是能让人印象深刻。
Sense of humor is always memorable.
是的，虽然是个仙人呐，但非常有亲切感。真像是一位热心的邻居。
Always approachable like a kind neighbor.
在刘云以闲云之名正式入住璃月港，成为我们的邻居之前，他到底经历了些什么？大伟哥肯定也很好奇他过去的故事吧？哎呀，我的聊天讲故事的本事肯定没他好。
Not as good as telling stories and chatting as she is.
就让我们一起期待
海灯节。Oh, okay, this is her story chapter. It's gonna be available soon.
可以，每次有刘云真君的剧情啊，都挺欢乐的，我很期待。哦。我们是不是该改口叫他闲云了？
没错，那我也来分享一下闲云在战斗时的风采吧。
Here we go.
The secrets of the mechanical arts are too profound to convey in a few simple words. Oh, but why must the listener grow weary whenever I begin to divulge them? Skyward!
Bro, that's so cool.
Stray clouds converge!
流云借风真君这个称号，再加上鹤的外形，不难让人联想出轻盈御风的仙人形象。闲云能进行至多三次的特殊跳跃。
Okay, hold on, let me read this again. Skylighter can be used in midair. She leaps forward, dealing enable damage to targets along her path. During each cloud transmogrification state, Skylighter may be used up to 3 times, and only 1 instance of Skylighter damage can be dealt to any one opponent. If Skylighter is not used again in a short period, the cloud transmogrification state will be cancelled. If Shen Yun does not use Drift Cloud Wave while in this state, the next CD of white clouds at dawn will be decreased. That's probably her burst.
不天梯 并且能根据具体情况在后两段中选择地
面释放。 So her elemental skill can be used three times basically.
这个过程中还能化形为鹤进行特殊的下落攻击。不仅如此，仙云更能轻换天空，召唤自己引以为傲的发明创造机关竹心，在持续恢复同伴生命值的同时，
then her burst is what enables plunge.
也能御风助推，让同伴获得轻盈的跳跃能力，提升跳跃的高度，并在同伴完成下落攻击时造成风元素范围伤害。
Notice how when she uses her burst, there's like a thing that looks like a kite that stays next to the active character.So you know how long you can plunge for, because as long as you'll have the little bird next to you, that's when your plunges are boosted. So you can see right next to him right here.
让同伴获得轻盈的跳跃能力，提升跳跃的高度，并在同伴完成下落攻击时造成风元素范围伤害，让整个队伍都如有先助。
And then when it disappears, that's when you should switch characters again.
而且还能为大家提供协助。就像是一位默默关照他人的热心长辈。
是的，希望能把闲云的这份人格魅力。
Which is great, because having a visual indication really helps.
那除了这两位有趣的角色之外，这次我们还有机会邀请到哪些角色入队呢
？Okay, here we go. Banners.
那就来看4.4版本的活动祈愿吧。在4.4版本，闲云与纳西达将会在。
Okay, so I'm pulling for Crow Retainer on my main, and my alt doesn't have Nahida yet, so I'm pulling for Nahida on the alt.
一期活动祈愿中出现，并提升获取概率。同时加名的获取概率也将大幅提升。
Jamming, I'll get him for sure. Both on the banner and probably in the free character from the festival as well.
在第二期活动祈愿中，萧和八重神子也将迎来复刻，并获得概率 up。
Bro, getting either one of those two, is gonna depend on the leaks for 4.5 and what's gonna come in 4.5. Because if there's characters I want more in 4.5, I won't pull for them.
那我的分享就告一段落了，大伟哥可以去尼龙部那边看看，那里还会有其他同事来和大伟哥讲讲沉玉谷的故事。
好的好的，也谢谢阿然的分享。那么在去尼龙部之前啊，我们先来看看第一组兑换码吧。
Okay, they're gonna paste redemption codes, but that's old news. I don't think they're even active anymore, so I'm just gonna skip that.No point in just sitting here and watching the screen. Here we go. Camellia Night. Oh, it's a song. Alright.
哥，你感觉沉玉谷的景色怎么样？
我还没看到太多，目前感觉还挺美的。
Give me one of those.
世外桃源的感觉。
I wonder if the king. I wonder if one of them just picks it up at needs during the filming.
还真有点世外桃源的感觉。
I totally would.
是吧？而且目前看来啊，沉玉谷这边的人文建筑好像都有点徽派建筑的味道。
没错没错。
They're talking about the atmosphere. Wow, not wow. Look at that. Hold on.Wow, that looks beautiful.
到犀牛河川，而徽派建筑这
The color palette is amazing. Look at that. Look at all the shades of green.
这种白墙黑瓦、色彩分明的特点就更是锦上添花，让村落看上去鳞次栉比、井然有序。
哎，说起水啊，沉玉谷这边水还挺多的。
No lack of water, true.
大大小小的溪流河川可是真不少。尼龙部这里啊，还有条这么高这么大的瀑布，气势磅礴啊！
Towering waterfall.
确实，这就得给大伟哥讲讲尼龙部这里流传的传说了。
哦，
大伟哥应该知道，璃月港的人们都相信这片土地最早的主人。
People in Liyue Harbor believe that the first lord of all Liyue was Rex Lapis.
先民正是跟随着阎王帝
君在他的护佑下 followed Rex Lapis.
才建立起了繁荣的城市和港口
So it was his protection that allowed them to establish the city.
不错
But there's a but.
在成玉谷也有人相信
There are people in Chenyu Vale that believe that apart from Rex Lapis, there are other gods and adepti who protected their ancestors in Chenyu Vale.
比如说啊在伊隆布这里
Here in Yilong Wharf, everybody has heard a certain legend about a car adaptus known as Fujin. That's how I name my wanderer. My wanderer is called Fujin.
嗯，也可以这么想。在当地的传说中啊，金色的鲤鱼可是好运的象征。
Golden carp is a symbol of good luck.
而且伊隆布衔接着枫丹，是两国之间重要的交通贸易枢纽。
The city borders on Fontan.
嘉明任职的剑侠镖局就在伊隆布。可以看到
The agency where Jiaming works is in.
自古就是座难以攀援的高山，在过去的传说中也曾是仙人隐居。
It was once a hidden home of the Adepti.
后来啊，因为种种缘故，一些仙民迁居至此，形成了新的居所。
Some ancestors moved here from a new settlement to overcome the inconvenience caused by towering waterfalls. So they built up a water powered lift for lazy people like me.
而且这瀑布之下还有一条蜿蜒曲折的大河。
There's a river that goes through the entirety of Chenyu Vale.
我们沿着河川看过去，大伟哥应该也注意到了河道上那堆
巨大的玉石了吧？
那里就是宝爵口，
算
是成玉谷中最有名的地标之一了。
It's a famous landmark.
是呀，这堆玉爵应该也是过去的仙人留下的吧？像这么壮观又瑰丽的景色，应该也只有仙人能创造出来吧？
传说宝爵口的这对玉爵就是仙人为了保护。
Legend has it that an adeptus cast down this jade's jade mouth to protect the people from flooding. Wow.
人民防洪治涝而投下的。
哈哈，心系人民的仙人确实还挺值得大家敬爱啊！这里的种种传说，听上去感觉还挺浪漫的。
是的，我们也来看看成玉谷的其他地方吧，像柠檬山。是历史悠久的古华派的发祥地。
Okay, so this is the place of the Guhua clan.
和悬链山就分别是传说中白蛇和鲤鱼仙人的住所。还有南方的赤章城垣是属于昔日冲突的遗迹。
成玉谷还真辽阔啊！
和刚才说的一样，
it's pretty big zone.
这片土地上还到处都遗留着仙人的足迹，宝器啊，洞府啊，说不定就散落在这雾气缭绕的高山之间呢。
你别说，成玉谷也有不少高山。但我总感觉和以往常见到璃月山岩还不太一样。
成玉谷这边的山岭
It's different from what we've seen of Leo before.
这些山南的颜色好像是水墨画一样，时不时还会有一抹
There's a greenish tint that brings them to life.
再加上山岭之间还藏着各种各样的奇特景观，我就觉得呀，成玉谷之所以会有这么多仙人的传说流传后世。和这种独一无二的地理风貌应该是密不可分的吧。
Legends are inseparable from the landscape.
大自然还真有鬼斧神工啊！
当你漫游成玉谷的时候，登临山岭高处，就会看到那些跌宕起伏的云海。
You behold
根据日光的变化，呈现出
a sea of clouds falling around you. Nice.
缭绕的云雾轻轻拂过你的身边，简直就像是置身仙境一样。
哎呀，你也太会描述景色了，说的我的期待值都拉满了。
还不止这些哦，除了仙迹和美景，成玉谷中还栖息着传说中的灵兽哦。
Legendary mythical beasts.
隐山泥兽。
Oh, new boss, hold on. A proud eliminated beast once roamed freely among the wild mountains, looking down disdainfully at other life. To this day, remains concealed in fog, driving away all outsiders who dare to encroach upon its territory. Okay, this is probably the boss that drops the cloud retainer materials.
据老人的说法。他们是这片土地原本的主人，如今隐居在崇山峻岭之间。虽然说是传说中的祥瑞之
兽 yep, he's definitely an
animal. 但若是有人贸然闯入他们的领地，打扰了他们的安宁，也是会被毫不留情地赶出去的哦。
他的外形啊，包括战斗表现都好仙好灵哦，我喜欢。
顺带一提，仪农部家喻户晓的武兽戏，这就是以传说中离兽的形象为原型进行的表演。嘉明身边的文仔其实也是泥兽哦，
看来这之间也有故事啊。
那就来看看
There's gonna be story behind Jamming's companion、
oh, that's quite
called Mai Chai.
Oh, that's so cute.
So are the stories true, sir? That's so cute.
Patience now. Any discussion of this beast must first begin with Chenyu Vale, a land of tiered peaks shrouded in billowing mist. replete with stories of illuminated beasts. As for the subject of your curiosity, let us call it the Solitary Swanee. It is a symbolic and auspicious animal, said to be related to the Adepti. Legends say the Swanee traverses the land under the cover of mist, its presence nearly indetectable, save only for the faintest outline of horns. When at ease, it rests with its eyes closed and legs crossed. Yet should the situation turn dangerous, the fury of the Swanee will be unleashed. It moves with the swiftness of windswept clouds, and attacks with the ferocity of a roaring waterfall. But some people say this time of peace has forced the Swanee into a life of seclusion far beyond our reach. Still, those are just a few old legends I've heard in my time. Getting all that across in a wushu dance might prove tricky, no?
It's like anything. Practice makes perfect. I just gotta work at it. You see? Manzai agrees with me.
成语谷这么辽阔，一下子是讲不完的。
Given how vast it is, there's no way we could have covered it in all in one.
就连香茶的气味也变得不如从前了。
One patch?
到时候还烦请各位旅行者跟随先人的指引，帮助解决困扰俏音庄居民的。
One girl, she said.
See,
Christ is troubling the residents.
再次感谢两位同学给我们带来了这么精彩的成语谷介绍，以及传说故事。
Almost gives the impression that Shenyu Vale will be featured in more than just one patch.
准备了解一下今年海灯节的活动吧。
Okay, I'm gonna skip the redemption code again, guys. Because if it's not expired, it should expire soon, and you can find it online at elsewhere. Wait. Here we go.
各位，欢迎回来。接下来啊，就让我们和阿明一起来看看今年的海灯节吧。Okay,
he's gonna talk about the Lantern Rite event.
听了刚才的一些铺垫啊，我还真挺期待今年海灯节的。今年都会有一些什么样的惊喜呢？
那么我就来抛砖引玉一下。刚才阿然也提到，今年海灯节的主题是风筝。Theme
is sky.
礼乐的传统手工艺风筝与风丹的械动式垂直拉升装置进行。
They'll be combined with mechanical vertical lifting devices.
哪个技术力更强啊？这可不好说呀。And
Claritiner's competing with Fontaine.
但是我对风筝了解不是特别多，为什么会选用风筝来当主题呢？我想可能是它能承载。
Kites are a symbol of hope. That's why they chose it. They're similar to Xiao
lanterns.
This time, our kites will light up the night as well. Bro, I wonder if they're gonna give us a pet for Lantern Rite this year. Probably.
比如锦鲤、龙凤、彩蝶，这些图案都很有特色。除了表达美好的祝愿，也能让看到的人们感受到祝福。而且放风筝本身也是非常有益身心的活动。是的，大伟哥也可以先来海灯节里体验体验。而且在今年海灯节上，参与者
Ganyu and Shanhei will be wearing new outfits来和大家共度佳节。 That Claritiner commissioned and Singshou as well. As long as you reach a specific goal, you get Singshou's outfit for free. Here we go, the outfits. That's pretty cool. Ganyu's is the best one, sorry, not gonna lie. I'm a big fan of Ganyu. Her outfit looks amazing. I'll bet she's gonna be 4.5.
Really nice.
明明是来给大伟哥介绍海灯节的，我自己都想快点入手新衣装了。
Okay, so hold on. As this year's end approaches, the annual lantern ride is about to begin. As is customary, you and Paimon return to Liyue Harbor once again, and as expected, you encountered some familiar faces. Take part in the event and earn. And then there's Primogems, Crown, XP Books, Weapon Ascent Chain, and the Sanctuary Outfit.
讲讲今年海灯节上都有一些什么有意思的活动吧。
好嘞。
今年海灯节上主要有三个游玩活
动。Three main activities.
分别是指引巡遥、瑞兽欢悦和异光云行。
Paper Shadows.Are foraging, joyful beasts under auspices, and iridescent crowds riding.
感觉光听名字就能有一个模糊的概念了。
他们的灵感源自各种传统文化，不过我们就像客勤一样，也在学习，尝试推陈出新。
好好好，快讲讲怎么个推陈出新法。
那先来说说这个指引巡遥吧。拆解名字的话，就是用指引的形式来寻觅
佳肴。To go foraging for tasty food.
指应句，灵活运用画片和灯具，
可以让画面在屏幕上活起来。再结合风单的映影相关技术，
改编成一种新颖的互动游戏。
Novel type of interactive game called Paper Theater.
主要会讲述些简单明快的
故事。Probably kind of like 3.8, I'm guessing.
我大概有概念了。结合这张锅巴和月桂的图啊，这出剪纸戏应该是引导锅巴和月桂去找食材。
It's about guoba and yuguai finding tasty ingredients.
没错没错，这个活动玩法呢，操作上比较简单，老少皆宜。我们需要控制锅巴和月桂进行移动，在特定的步数限制下解开谜题，破除障碍。
Kind of like a board game.
最后一起收集到食材，就可以成功烹饪出各种美味佳肴了。这个规则是不是看起来还蛮简单的？
的确门槛不高，玩一遍应该就会了，确实很有节庆气氛。
不过呢，也不要太过小看这个游戏了，在后几关挑战中可能需要引导锅巴与月桂互相配合。
In the end, you're gonna have to make the two of them work together to get the ingredients.
这样月桂就能在不同的起始点开始行动，也能节省下一些步数。
有意思，像是推箱子一样。
Pushing boxes around.
瑞兽欢悦是武
圣队在武
圣戏的基础上进行了简化。
Is the new Wushou dance gameplay?
希望大家能够在茶余饭后活动活动，同时也能亲身感受一下武兽戏的魅力。
哎，不错哎，武兽戏啊，看着就挺有意思的，但要自己去体验武兽门槛还是有点高的。那这个趣味活动啊，说不定能给我们带来不一样的火花。
这个火花可是靠碰撞出来的哦。这个活动共有三个关
卡。Three stages in total. 历史
连连来。时节竞登高和彩青争
旗照。 Okay, so this is co-op.
可以通过匹配让店家帮忙组局，也可以自行邀请亲朋好友组团游玩。当进入关卡场地后，我们需要在限定时间内达成不同的关卡目标，尽可能取得更高的评分。在这个过程中还可以穿戴特制的武兽系玩偶。
Okay, so yeah, it's not only co-op, but it's competitive.
触碰到的其他玩家。
It's about collecting the most.
确实很欢乐。
Coins.
而且在游玩过程中还可以稍微使点小坏，弹开其他朋友来争夺更多的积分。
Sending your friend flying to win more points. Wow,
that's gonna be fun. 抢积分也要来弹开我。
那也不能光顾着使坏啊，三个关卡还是有一些特定规则的，比如力士连连来最容易上手，最重要的目标就是去争夺尽可能多的力士茶饼，去弹开别的玩家也能获得他掉落的茶饼。时节竞登高还额外要去抢占时不时出现的高地来保持豪气值，同时也可以通过
you have to fight in the platforms. Wow.
彩青征集绕的话，主要就是要前往时不时刷新的安全区域里，规避掉麻辣气氛的影响，从而保持清淡值。当然既然出现了安全区域，
你 gotta send the safe zones in the last
trial, 让他进不了安全区域。
And you can prevent other players from getting to the safe zones, bro. That's gonna be so fun.
你先损友一步。
最后一个活动，异光云行，我们可以借助金里浮月的力量，在烟花绽放的空中穿梭，并在这个过程中收集尽可能多的玉莲灯笼来积累得分。还请放心。
Yeah, this mini game looks like the ones in 3.8.
不会让烟花伤害到我们的。
化为精力穿梭于烟花绽放的夜空中。
You can fly through the skies and form a golden card.
希望海灯节的故事与活动能把这份喜庆又吉祥的节日气氛传达给每一位旅行者。当节庆热度足够高涨，各位可以从十位
旅行角色中任选一位邀请加入到你的队伍来。Okay, I'm getting jamming here for sure. Unless I get him in a burnt banner first.
其中也包括我们的新朋友佳明哦。
If I do get him in the banner, I'm getting Yao Yao because I don't think I have her on my
main account. 也会在海灯节期间开放。旅行者们可以领取最多十枚纠缠之源在内的奖励。同时
，Wait, wait, hold on.
旅行者们在过去一年里的支累计登录活动“富贵登门”也会在海灯节期间。
Okay, I gotta read this. You can from February 3rd to February 18th, you can get 10 of Intertwined Fate by checking in during the event period.So that whole thing about the Chinese law preventing people from earning rewards by logging in daily is completely gone because they're basically doing exactly that. So by logging in 10 days between February 3rd and February 18th, you can get 10 fates. Which obviously we're going to do it. I want those 10 fates for sure. Lantern Rite gifts. I don't see any pets though. Yeah, you can get a new Liyue character. You can get 10 fates, and you can earn fates and materials at the Lantern Rite gifts.
期间开放，旅行者们可以领取最多十枚纠缠之源在内的奖励。同时，为了感谢旅行者们在过去一年里的支持与陪伴。
We're also going to use in-game mail to send you all three intertwined fates. Let's go! Okay, so not only will we get like primogems like normal, we're also getting 10 intertwined fates by logging in for 10 days during the event. And they're gonna mail us three fates for just, you know, thank you for spending the year with us.
海灯佳节之际，大家都能。
Adam, I'm watching the 4.4 Genshin special event, so I'm reacting to a video right now.
放飞承载梦想与祝愿的风筝，乘风到达理想的地方。
没错，也祝愿各位能和亲朋好友一同享受欢乐的时光。
说的对啊，不过我们的节目还没有结束，让我们先休息一下，看看第三组兑换码吧。
Okay, so they're gonna give another redemption code. I'm gonna skip that.So yeah, basically this year we're getting a new outfit for Xingqiu, a free Liyue character, 4-star, 13 fates regardless of primogems from the events. Bro. There's a lot of things. And all of this starts in 2 weeks more or less. Can't wait.I'll hydrate, thank you.
哥，你知不知道璃月现在已经吸引到越来越多不同地区的朋友前来游玩了？
当然知道，上次温迪不就来海灯节了吗？怎么说，今年又有新面孔？
是啊是啊，
Some new faces this year.
今年有一些朋友会来璃月共度海灯节。
There are some friends coming to
璃
月 to celebrate the Lantern together.
这是来尝璃月菜来了。
虽然可能初衷不是这个，但就结果来看确实是这样。起因其实是我们接下了望舒客栈的委托，暂时
Receive your friends from afar，
成为了望舒客栈的代理大厨。
That's another event.
满足远道而来的客人们对璃月佳肴的好奇心，
让我想到了一句老话，叫有朋自远方来，
不亦乐乎。蒙德、道七、须弥和枫丹都会有我们熟悉的朋友们前来。
Okay, there's gonna be familiar faces from, hold on, let me read that. Let me read that, hold on one second. I wanna see who they are.
须弥和枫丹都会有我们熟悉
的朋友们前来。 Mondstadt, Inazuma, Sumeru, and Fontaine. Okay, cool.
熟悉的朋友们前来，至于他们的目的以及在这里发生了什么，就请各位旅行者届时亲自去揭晓答案吧。
那看来必须得好好露一手，让他们尝尝地道的璃月菜了。
I think that's when Aether will encounter Lumine.
改刀、调配、烹制
Maybe,
这三个步骤，来烹饪出符合客人需求的
菜品。So we're gonna be cooking.
最后再对菜品进行摆盘装饰，就可以邀请客人们品尝了。
不错不错，招待朋友这事儿我最开心了。
另外，最近蒙德也正发生着一些
神秘事件。Wait, what's this?Mysterious statues have suddenly appeared in the Dalpa Gorge. In their villages, the Hilichol tribes are behaving strangely. There must be some secret in the depths of those places for adventurers to discover. Damn, that's another event.
有些神秘的雕像突兀地出现在达达乌帕谷中，导致丘丘人部落中的丘丘人们突然变得举止反常起来。
这时候就需要我们前去调查其中暗藏的真相和秘密了，对吧？
没错，大伟哥已经是一位非常优秀的旅行者了。
毕竟也旅行了这么久，
我们需要先操控乌帕。
You have to use the eye of a pano to attach yourself to Hilichurls and Animal Slimes.
丘丘人与风史莱姆身上，潜入部落营地中。
To infiltrate the tribe's camps, while carefully avoiding or guys interfering with some trolls who can see through your disguise.
直到抵达营地深处，找到并调查那些。
You need to find and investigate the mysterious statues.
这潜行看起来好流畅哦。
调查完雕像后。我们将能造访幽深的秘境。
Once investigate them, you enter deep domain.
非常硕大的丘丘萨满。
Where are you gonna fight a large summer troll?
非常强大，我们需要见招拆招，把他的能力转化为我们的武器进行反制。例如击破他召唤的六倍大日落。
And here we can see Xiao plunging using Cloud Retainer's ability. Hold on, let's watch that again. See, this is when he Xiao plunges using.
依附在丘丘人与风史莱姆身上，
潜入部
落营地中，同时需要小心地避开或者干扰那些能识破我们伪装的丘丘萨满，直到抵达营地深处，找到并调查那些神秘的雕像。
这潜行看起来好流畅哦！
调查完雕像后，
我
们将能造访幽深的秘境。
There we go. Shao using Crow Retainers.
非常硕大的丘丘萨满，这丘丘萨满非常强大，我们需要见招拆招。把他的能力转化为我们的武器进行反制，例如击破他召唤的六倍大日落果，使他在地面残留的果汁中。
Bro is using Xiao, Cloud Retainer, Farina, and Nuvolet.
用他召唤的大型风场飞起来，并使用下落攻击的冲击波战胜他等等。
用他的力量来战胜他，听起来很刺激啊！
除了丘丘人部落的神秘雕像，在波诡云谲的秘境深处。还有其他来历成谜的敌人。
Whoa, there's even more. In the depths of a mysterious domain, treacherous foes of even more mysterious origins are preparing for battle. Carefully analyze the opposing lineup and adapt to swiftly dispatch your foes.
正在蓄势备战。每个挑战包含四轮战斗，在不同战斗轮次中，我们可以从
Okay, they're gonna give us trial characters. Good.
选择两或四位加入队伍。每名角色初始具有两点战役值。
Every character starts with two resolve, and then as you use them, they lose resolve. So you can only use each character twice.
会根据队伍中角色战役值的总和提供特定效果。我们需要留意该效果，并合理加以利用。最终完成挑战，获取奖励。
感觉可以借助试用角色去尽情尝试一些新的配对和战略。
对的，希望旅行者能享受不同的配对带来的战斗体验。除此之外。七圣召唤也有一些更新。
Updates to Geniusification CG。
除了常规的热斗模式更新，七圣召唤的铸境岩链也将再次开放。 旅行者可以选择不同的附加条件，获取积分。
Bro, I can never get into TCG. I'm just not a fan.
其次，精通已有活动也将如期而至，需要培养角色的旅行者们不要错过。最后，说到培养角色，针对圣遗物的养成体验也在。
Okay, artifact loadouts.
本次增加了圣遗物快速装备的新功能，旅行者可以选择自定义方案。
Zyox did unspeakable horrors to get this.
更方便的装备圣遗物哦，
感觉很实用哎，期待一下，也感谢阿明带来的分享。
大伟哥客气了，预祝大家海灯节快乐！
海灯节快乐
！Alright, that was the video.
除了提瓦特的朋友们与我们共度佳节
，Now he's just gonna do like a conclusion.
也有其他朋友用自己的方式给我们准备了惊喜。
Oh, okay, now he's talking about the OnePlus thing for cell phones. I don't want to watch that. This is basically like advertising for OnePlus. They did like a special phone with a Kuching theme. We can skip this part. Alright, that's pretty cool. I'm really excited. I think Lantern Ride is going to be amazing. Can't wait.Hold on. Opening game. That's not the game, that's me. Here we go.